Okay, here we have 2a minus 1 fourth b minus 2c, and we want to find out what the resultant is. So the first thing we're going to do, we're going to work with the a vector. The a vector has a magnitude of 80 newtons. So we need to double this because it says multiply it by 2. So what we're going to do is I'm going to move this vector out of the way, or the magnitude out of the way. I'm going to extend this to represent 160. Okay, at this point we can get rid of this, and we're just going to write in as 160 newtons. We'll do that in red. Okay, now we're coming to the b. Now the b is being multiplied by 1/4, and then it has a negative applied. So what it's going to do is it's going to reverse it, and it's going to shorten it. So we're going to shorten it first. So first thing, we'll draw a vector that's about a quarter less long. Oh, get a vector here, sorry. Vector that's about quarter as long as that one. We're going to give a value of 10 because 40 times 1/4 would give me 10. Then we're going to reverse the direction of this vector. So it's going to go back the other way. I'll try to get it fairly straight. Let me move some of my stuff out of the way. Straight, and then we're going to move it into place. And we'll put the 10 over here. And now we are done with this vector, and we'll just delete it. We don't need it anymore. All right, and the last one, we have a 70. We want to multiply it by 2 and then reverse it. So it's going to go back up this way. And again, I try to get that as parallel as I can. And it's going to have a value of 140 newtons. And now we can just eliminate this vector. But before I do that, let's go ahead and we can eliminate this. But before I do it, we need to move the 70 back into place. The 70 degrees is between the x-axis and the vector. So up here, it has to be between the x-axis and the vector because those are vertical angles. Now we can get rid of this vector. And now all we have to do is sum the forces because these are all forces. We'll do that in black. We sum the forces in the x direction. And again, we're going to set that, whatever the result of this is going to give us the magnitude of the x component of a resultant. When we do that, the 10 only has an x, so we do a 10. We do plus 160 times the cosine of 35. And again, the reason we're doing the cosine is because if we look at the components of this vector here, it would be like this and like this. Okay, tail, tail here, head, tail, and then head, head. So it has a positive x and a positive y. So we'll go ahead and just delete those. We don't need those. But all right. So now I'll put this in parentheses, which you don't necessarily have to. We'll work with the 140. That's going to be minus 140 times the cosine of 70 degrees. Again, if you're confused about that, just remember your components start tail tail here. It goes out and then goes up. So we have a negative x and a positive y. Now the other thing, it doesn't matter whether you did the y first. You could have gone this way. You'll notice you're going to get the same thing. You need a positive y and then a negative x. Okay, so we'll go ahead and get rid of these. Okay, so that's where I get the negative 140. And the reason I use the cosine again, because this side is adjacent to the 70. All right, we'll run that through our calculator. And I believe when I do that, we get 93.18 newtons. Now we do the y the same way. Sum the force in the y. Okay, this has no y component, so there's no reason to even include that. We immediately go to the 160. Make that equal sign a little better. Actually, let's erase that. Equals to 160 times the sine of 35 plus 140 times the sine of 70. Again, earlier we said that this has a positive y. That's all the forces we have, and that's going to give me 223.33 newtons. at this point. I'll scroll down, I'll give myself a little space. Right now you go immediately go to Pythagorean theorem, and we know the magnitude of the resultant vector is going to equal to the square root of 93.18 squared plus 223.33 squared. We take the square root of that. That will give us a value of 241.99 newtons. That's the magnitude of our resultant vector. And now all we have to do is get the direction. Easiest way to get the direction is draw vectors representing these. These are both positive. So we'll come over here. We will draw our first vector positive. We will label that as 93.18. We'll draw our next vector going up to represent the 223. And again, it would be useful to draw these to some type of proportional scale. And you don't have to, it just makes life easier. Let me move that back because that looks like it's out of place. Now we know our hypotenuse would be from tail here to head here. And then we know our angle, we'll call that theta, is right there. And by definition, we know the tangent of theta is opposite over adjacent. Extend down a little bit, and then we know that theta is equal to the inverse tan of 223.33 divided by 93.18. We run that through our calculator, and we will find that theta is equal to 67.35 degrees. So at this point, we have our magnitude and we have our angle. So all we have to do is rewrite this and say that the R vector is equal to 241.99, and you've got to include the units, so we include newtons, and the angle is 67.35. And we'll circle that in blue, and that is your answer. Okay? All right, best of luck with these problems.